We are going to look at a technique of graphing vectors using arrow diagrams. We're going to use something that is essentially an XY coordinate system without being an XY coordinate system. We're going to be given some givens, and we are going to make use of a protractor to make these diagrams. Now, on each of these problems, I also have written simplifying information in here to help us understand what we're looking at. So the first vector that we're going to do is named V. They typically are named U and V when you get problems that you work on. They could be any variable, really. But this one's going to be vector V. It's going to represent 55 miles per hour traveling at a bearing of north 30 degrees west. So this is a type of quadrant bearing problem. All the angles phi are between 0 and 90 degrees, so this 30 falls between there. And it's giving us an east or west of the north-south axis. So the north-south axis is like your y-axis, the east-west is like your x-axis. So north-south y, east-west x, just like a standard compass. So we also, if we're going to represent this, the two basic ideas between a vector is that it has a magnitude and direction. So magnitude is talking about the length, and direction means kind of which angle that we're using here. So the 55 is going to act like our magnitude. The direction is going to be the 30 degrees. So when we do this, this is not necessarily a true XY axis, but we can make it something like that. We're going to have to establish a scale. And for the purpose that we need right now, I'm going to use an eighth of an inch representing 5 miles per hour, since we have to represent 55 units essentially. So when I measure with my measuring device here, I have this ruler along the bottom. I'm going to use every eighth of an inch represents 5 miles per hour. So the first thing that I want to do is I want to draw my arrow. So these are called arrow diagrams. We're going to draw an arrow. And so I need to figure out what is 30 degrees west of north. So north is up here. West is out here. So we're going to be in this quadrant here. So this is west of north. So we want 30 degrees in here. So we're going to measure from north towards the west 30 degrees. So when you bring your protractor in here, you should have kind of a little crosshair sight in here. You want to line that up with the intersection of your north-south east-west axis. And there's a line here that should be right in line with this axis. There's a line here that should be right in line with the other axis. And that way you know you're square. Notice I have two gauges here. One counts from zero up and one counts from 180 down. Since we are trying to get 30 degrees, we're going to start with our, we're counting from north. So we're starting with zero and counting up to 30 degrees. So as I move this direction, I see 30 degrees is here. I'm going to make a little mark out here at 30 degrees. And then I'm going to use this bottom edge of the protractor as a straight edge, and then I'm going to connect that point to the origin. And I don't have to come out all the way here. But I'm drawing this arrow out here, and I'm going into my words. I don't know if that's going to affect anything or not. So now I need this length to represent the 55 miles per hour. So I said the scale that I want to use is an eighth of an inch equals 5 miles per hour. So I'm going to come back in here and I'm going to measure. Every eighth of an inch represents 5 miles per hour. So 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 55. Right here is going to give me that. So now I'm going to come in, I'm going to darken this in with my pen. All right, so this area that I darkened in, that is the vector V that I'm looking for. It has a magnitude of something that represents 55 miles per hour, and it has a direction. It's 30 degrees west of north. You might want to put some kind of a label out here for your scale. We used an eighth of an inch equals 5 miles per hour. That way everybody knows what they're looking at in your arrow diagram. So this is our vector. It shows an arrowhead here, but that does not mean that it continues on. This is not a ray like you learned about in geometry class. A vector has a set distance and a direction. So the arrow is kind of indicating direction, not that it continues on. Let's look at another problem. Our givens are done slightly different. So this time we have vector U is 16 knots at a bearing of 095 degrees. This is a true bearing problem, which means you start at north and you count clockwise, measuring your degrees. This is like a practical sailing problem. This is if you are doing paper and pencil navigation marks, this is something that is true to life that you would need to know. And I already made this statement. All right, so knots are like miles per hour, only it's speed for boats. This is slightly faster than miles per hour. There's like 1.15 statute miles, which is what you drive on the road, in one nautical mile. So a nautical mile is slightly longer distance. So if you went one nautical mile in an hour, you have gone farther than one statute mile in an hour. We're bearing 095, so we're counting from north and we're counting clockwise when we're doing true bearings. And true bearings are done in three numbers. That helps avoid confusion when communicating. A lot of things that you do in sailing and aviation in the military, you have to make sure that you eliminate as many mistakes as possible. All right, so we're going to measure 95 degrees this way. So when I bring my protractor back in, I'm going to have it flipped opposite of what I had before. I'm going to line up the crosshairs with the origin again. Make sure that this bar is lined up with this east-west, and this bar is lined up with the north-south. But I have it flipped this way because I'm measuring clockwise this time, not counterclockwise. Starting from zero again, I'm counting down to 95. And we can still get an idea. One little trick that I use, if I run off the paper, I can set another piece of paper beside it and get the mark that I need. Set this over here so you can see this. There's 90, so we need 95. I'm going to mark that. I'm going to use my pencil again because I don't want to mark anything permanently until I know what length that I need. So I'm connecting that mark to the origin. So I have this line right here. I'm going to darken that in once I find out the length that I need, the magnitude of my vector. So I'm going at 16 knots. This time, the scale that I'm going to choose to use is I'm going to use a 16th of an inch equals 1 knot. All right, so I'm using a different scale this time. This is good for us to see. So I'm going to come back in here and I'm going to measure again. This time I'm using 16ths of an inch. And I'm going to measure right down this segment that I drew here. I'm going to make sure that my zero mark is where the origin is here. And then I'm just going to count 16 out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. And so that I find that's an inch. Some of you probably already realized that's where we were going to end up. So from here back to the origin is my vector. I put my arrowhead here. So this is my vector u. This represents a magnitude of 16 knots at a true bearing of 95 degrees. So that's this angle here. That is the 95 degrees. Those are two examples of doing arrow diagrams for givens using a protractor. Cheerful Calculations.